moment of truth. It really did. It really did that.
Today, I'm going to teach you how to vibe code a video game like this from scratch. I'm your host, Nilo. I am not a software developer, but I write software every day. Welcome to Vibecoding. I'll tell you what we're not going to do. We're not going to talk about
all the different coding languages. We're not going to talk about frameworks. We're not going to talk about the various apps that you can use.
Like trying to learn music theory before you're allowed to touch the piano. No, we're just going to make something. Even if you've never dreamed of making a video game before, I think you will find this to be one of the most rewarding ways to learn. And it's an excellent source of show and tell next time you're at a family dinner and they ask you what you're doing with your life. And you say, funny you should ask. Let's dive in. If you haven't, you will need to pick your battle axe. There are a ton of AI tools out there. Right now, I'm using one called Cursor. It's my current favorite, highly recommend. But many of them are great if you prefer Windsurf or Replit or any of the others. This process will be nearly identical across all of them, so feel free to follow along on your platform of choice. If you're new to all of them and overwhelmed by the choice, just go with Cursor. They give you 2 weeks to start for free, which is more generous than most of them. All of them will typically run you between $15 to $20 a month for the pro subscription. Luckily, that will be the only cost you'll likely incur, but if you can afford it, it's money well spent. So, whichever you choose, download it, make an account, open it, and let the games begin. Literally, games. Step one will be to create a folder. It's funny how many people want to pass this up. Don't do it. Coding projects are not like a Microsoft Word document where there's just one file. Each project will have numerous files, sometimes hundreds, maybe more. So step one, create a folder and then name it whatever you want. Open your program. Mine, of course, is Cursor. And then open project, go to your folder, wherever you put it, and then open that. Now we're inside your folder and everything that you create from here will be stored correctly. Here in the right, this is where you will click and type your prompt. Now, I recommend entering these exact words, and I'll tell you why in a minute. Build a simple Tetris game for the web without frameworks. And then press enter. Now, why did I use those specific words? I told it two things. For the web, which means build me something that I can use in a web browser. That's the easiest kind of software to make, and right now we want easy. We want to win. I also said without frameworks. This basically means you're cueing your AI to not use any extra technology that you would need to download or that would create any external dependencies. This just minimizes complexities and is highly advisable for anyone starting out. It's working. While it does its thing, if for some reason you still see it asking you to install Node or NPM, don't do it. Just stop it and re-enter the prompt and try again. Now, when it's finished, it will likely offer you a command that you can just run to view it. If it doesn't, like it hasn't here, we'll just go accept all right here on the right. And then you can do two things. You can say, please launch the game so that I can view it. That'll work. Or you can also go over here to your file browser in the left and see all of the files that are currently in that folder you created earlier, nicely organized. And you can go directly to that file and then manually open it. So on a Mac, you right click. So control click, reveal in Finder, and then you can double click this. Or on a PC, right click, reveal in file browser, same thing, double click, and voila. Ooh, it looks great. Whoa. Okay, now let's see, what else can I do with this? So far, everything's working perfectly. It looks good, it functions. Let's see what happens when I get my first row. Boom. Oh my gosh, okay, amazing. Pause, wow. Is it perfect? I mean, maybe not, but we can definitely work with this. So, what do we do next? Well, we add features, we customize it, we make it whatever we want. I would love it if, when I get a point, the background flashes colors. So let's try that. Let's add a feature that makes the background flash rainbow colors whenever the score goes up. Okay. It looks so good already. Now we just wait and put on that mental Jeopardy music. Do 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 do. It's done. The grand reveal. Press accept, go back to the game, refresh, and let's get some points to find out what it looks like. Moment of truth. Oh, fantastic. Now, if you hit a snag and it's not working right away, not to worry. Very normal. That's going to happen. So you have two options at that point. You can tell your agent what's going on, ask it to fix it, or you can go back, restart a checkpoint, right here, restore checkpoint. Click that, it'll ask you this, continue. You can always undo this later. I'm gonna trust that we can, because I don't wanna undo it. And then you go back, type whatever prompt edits you want, if you want. Sometimes you can rerun the exact same prompt and it just magically fixes itself. So we don't wanna go back, so we will click back down here. It then automatically reinstates those changes and we can add more features. Can you make our bricks into caterpillars with green bodies and red faces? Well, it just says yes to everything. It really did. It really did that. Oh my gosh. Wow, this is amazing. Okay, we have to try harder to break it. Because this is cute as hell and I love this Tetris. And the rainbows are still working. Okay, pause. I love glitter. Can you make the background glitter? It's getting harder and harder to stump these agents. Your Tetris game has a beautiful glitter background. Let's find out what that looks like. Oh. Oh, it's almost like we're under the sea. Okay, but I don't like that, right? It's not continuous. That wasn't exactly what I was thinking. Can you make the sparkles consistent and also appear behind the bricks? You don't even have to try, it seems like, with the prompts anymore. You can just say anything and it's like, oh, yep, I got it. Dun, da, da, da. Oh, now that's what I'm talking about in our caterpillar game. Oh, okay, last thing and then we'll just move on. Can you add asteroids flying through the sky after every point? I need to find something it can't do. I'm trying to find something it can't do. Okay. Moment of truth on the asteroids. If this works, I quit. Oh my God, it really did come up with asteroids and they looked cool. Okay. Well, let's pretend that it didn't nail that. We're gonna go back here and what we would theoretically do at this point would be exactly what we described earlier. Restore checkpoint, rewrite the prompt, try something else, do it again, and see how it goes. This is the process. You can do this endlessly. You try something, you see how it goes, you don't like it, you refine it, you try again. Your game is going to be different from my game. If I started this process over again right now with the same exact prompts, I would have a different outcome. This isn't a bug, this is part of the beauty of it. You are collaborating. It's not just doing what you say, it's interpreting it and experimenting. So, let's recap. There are two important strategies that we used today that contributed to our success that I would love for you to carry with you when you go. One, we deliberately kept it simple. We added words like simple and phrases like no frameworks and for the web to our initial prompt. We didn't use databases, APIs, or frameworks. And if you don't even know what those terms are, that's okay. You don't need to right now. Two, we started with a basic idea first, and then we iterated on it. If you try to do too much at once, it's harder on your AI agent and you're more likely to break things. So start with something simple and then add features, add refinements. And that's it. We made a video game. Now it's your turn to play. Ask for fun stuff like adding sparkles, make laser beams go off whenever I get a point, whatever it is that you desire. If you run into a problem and you don't know what to do, just ask it. Your agent is there to work these things out with you. In future videos, we'll tackle more complex topics. But as for today, I hope that you now have a fun flashy show and tell worthy video game under your belt to give you a little bit of momentum going forward. If this was fun for you, like and subscribe so we know to do some more of these. Share in the comments what you built, how you liked the process, what you didn't like about the process. And now I'm gonna get back to my caterpillar asteroid rainbow Tetris. See you in the next one. Bye. Bam! This is really fun though, I'm gonna be honest. I really like this. I will definitely play this. We need a longy. Oh, this'll do.